It was truly Saturday afternoon fever for followers of the Tigers in 1978, and defense played a big part. Tony Williams and Bubba Brown make the big hit on the corner in an important conference game against North Carolina State. This was the game that saw the Tigers crawl into that favored role that the preseason prognosticators had said they would have. Offensively, Steve Fuller, Heisman Trophy candidate. And his favorite receiver, Jerry Butler, the All-American. And this one carries to the 2-yard line of the Wolfpack. This is a play that Steve Fuller himself called. Fourth down, Butler touchdown. Four receptions on the year for the young man from Willow Shoals, South Carolina, and that but one of them. Another young man named Brown. Lester Brown, tailback of the Tigers, and a 15-yard scamper to pay dirt, and another Tiger touchdown. Heisman Trophy candidate, NC State's Ted Brown, but on this play, he meets Bubba Brown and a group of his Tiger friends. Smith the pass for the Wolfpack. Bubba Rollins from cornerback and an interception for the Tigers, one of a record 22 on the season for the Clemson secondary. Talk about intercepts, talk about big plays. Smith again to throw for the Wolfpack, in trouble as he moves to his right. And junior Rex Varn picking it off 94 yards downfield for another Tiger TD. All in all, an exciting afternoon for followers of the Tigers as their team wins over North Carolina State on the road by a score of 33-10. The 18th, College Park, Maryland. The Tigers and the Terps for the ACC Championship. O'Hare back to throw, in trouble. Tony Williams and Jonathan Brooks, big defensive play. This game's for all the marbles. Again, O'Hare quarterbacking. Quick pass in the flat. But it's Rollins and Gibbs of the Tigers who were there to stop the play for no gain. Then on the offensive side of the ledger, the Tigers 83 yards away from the goal line. Treading by a score of 14-7. Fuller rolling left and finding his favorite receiver, All-American Jerry Butler, over the middle. And 83 yards later, it's another six for the Tigers. Regained the lead at 21-14, and the Tigers had their backs to the wall once more. But once more, it's the arm of Steve Fuller, and this time finding senior Dwight Clark over the middle, 64 yards to pay dirt again, and it's a 21-21 football game. Stated earlier, defense played a big part in the Tigers' success this year. Maryland on a halfback pass. But it's Bubba Brown and Tony Williams who spoil the day for the Terps. And in a big possession drive, the Tigers have the football for what ultimately will lead to the winning score of the day. Marvin Sims, one of two crunching fullbacks for the Tigers, busting up the middle, mowing down Maryland tacklers. Fleet Lester Brown from tailback. Touchdown, Lester Brown. largest crowd ever to witness a football game between Philadelphia and Birmingham turned out on November 25th to see the Tigers go against their ancient foe, the Gamecocks of South Carolina. Lester Brown, first possession of the afternoon, cracks over left tackle and fights his way into the 30-yard line. Several plays later, Steve Fuller from quarterback, and the Tigers are on top by a score of 6-0. South Carolina's Zion McKinney to receive. Upfield he comes. Then a big hit. The ball is loose. And it's Rick Wyatt of the Tigers recovering. And Clemson with possession again at the 35-yard line of South Carolina. That led to another score, and Clemson built up a 14-0 lead. Ecstatic. Later in the game, Steve Fuller from quarterback, big third down play, fakes the handoff, takes off on his own. Just a few of the 108 yards that Fuller recorded running on that beautiful November Saturday afternoon. Tracy Perry, the second man in a tandem of tough, strong fullbacks of the Tigers, 8 yards to pay dirt, and Clemson well on their way to victory once again. Climax to a 10-1 year, and this date in Jacksonville. After a 10-1 season, a date in the Gator Bowl, it appeared that all was well in Tiger Town. But was it in fact? Rumors began to fly. And then this statement from head coach Charlie Pell.
Not looking, and it's been ridiculous. We spend half our time talking to prospects and their parents, talking about trying to answer all the things that's said in the newspapers that have absolutely no basis. And we have rejected job offers already this year, and we're very happy at Clemson. And if we were to ever get a job offer, we'd react to them and at the right time. But all of this business is just on sheer speculation. That's what makes it so funny. We're going full speed in our recruiting program. We're close to having the best freshman class, I would think. I know it'd be the best freshman class I've ever been associated with in college football, and we're excited about it, and we're excited about what's going, and we're going full speed ahead in one single direction, and that's for Clemson. And I don't think there needs to be anything else said on that matter as far as I'm concerned.
Proud that he's going to be our next head football coach at Clemson, Danny Ford.
I'm very honored to be the football coach at Clemson. We've got some things we want to get accomplished here at Clemson. We're going to continue the program that has been started by the staff, by the previous staff that was here. And what we're hoping is that many of the same staff members will continue to be on the staff of our athletic program here.
And so it came to be that on December 5th, Danny Ford was given the job of coaching the Clemson Tigers. His first assignment, the Gator Bowl game, tonight, Ohio State. Of Ohio State, 7-3-1 on the season, and coached by unpredictable Woody Hayes. Quarterback Arch Leister, a passer here to Ron Springs, and a runner in this 7-yard TD scamper against Illinois. Schleister likes to go to wide receiver Rod Gerald. In the secondary, people like Bob Murphy here intercepting against Illinois. The Bucks can explode with tailback Ricky Johnson. Solid defense is a fort of Ohio State. And of course, again, there's always Woody Hayes.
On the beach, Florida. This is where it all begins, the countdown towards the 29th and the game against Ohio State in the Gator Bowl. Just those few moments of relaxation this morning before hitting the practice field for the first time. And when you look at a scenic view such as this one, you may think that it's a little tough to get your mind on football. But no, it's not, because picking up equipment is the order of the morning. And then heading out for what will be a week of hard contact as the Tigers prepare for Gator Bowl 1978.
The Daytona Beach end of the Tigers' preparation for their Gator Bowl date with Ohio State had its fun moments. Warm weather greeted the team, and the beach became a popular spot. It, in fact, looked to the outsider as though the Tigers might be on vacation. But don't be deceived by what you see.
You can't complain about the climate. Don't want you to get too much off of football, though.
Oh, yeah. We're down here to have a good time, like Coach Ford said, and enjoy ourselves in off times. But he's got certain times of the day for us to work, and we will work, knowing him as well as I do. And I think we'll be prepared, but have a good time at the same time.
I'll tell you, the schedule does look a little tough here at Daytona, because you're going to hit two-a-days, and that's big work.
Definitely. We'll practice at 9:30 and 3:30 twice a day down here. In the mornings, practicing up with about an hour and five, and afternoons, 2 hours, and afternoons, full pads. So it'll be kind of rough. It's going to be kind of tough getting back into things again. But once we get back into it, I'm sure, you know, like we say, we're down here for one purpose, and that's to win the football game and then have a good time.
You went through all of this a year ago, and there was big disappointment. Do you feel that the attitude's changed?
Definitely. Last year, we came down not knowing what to expect or how to go about, you know, handling the situation. But this year, like we say, we got 26 seniors back off that last year's team, and we know you got to come down here and prepare hard to play the football game and then play after the, you know, game's over with, stay down a few days.
Randy, obviously some time for fun and relaxation, fun and games, shall we say, but what about the game?
Well, you know, we made it clear. Coach told us last night the main thing we're dying for is to play football and win. He said, you know, we dedicate, you know, our practice sessions, our film sessions to the football, and otherwise he's just going to give us our time to play, you know, going swimming like we're doing now.
In the same respect, it's nice to have weather like this, isn't it?
Yes, it's nice to be home and it's warm. I couldn't play football up in North South Carolina. It's too cold now. But this is some nice weather, you know, just like spring.
Randy, now let me ask you a little bit about that first workout you had. That's some of your teammates come in to spoil the show for you. But nonetheless, a little about that first workout. Was it tough after a couple weeks away?
Yes, it was real tough, you know. Coming back, we took two weeks off. And we came back this week, and we started running today, and we did mostly conditioning. So next week, we ought to be all right.
Y'all get out of here.
This is what the Tigers did twice a day in Daytona. Practice sessions that ranged from a light hour and 15 minutes in the morning to a solid 2 hours of hard hitting in the afternoon. One needed only to be around these sessions to realize that the team is obviously intent on being totally prepared come December 29th.
Oh, Huh?
Rough field.
I swear, you haven't seen Chip Brooks now.
Oh.
Just like that number that's got sand right in the middle.
Danny Ford, head coach of the Tigers, but still in the pits with his offensive line, a line that he has built over the past 2 years, one that has seen the Tigers eclipse all total offense records. And they begin work towards the Gator Bowl game. Quarterback and receiver drills, there's Steve Fuller. I look next to Billy Lott. Mainland High School, Daytona Beach, Florida.
Well, believe it or not, here is a graduate of Clemson University as of, the 17th?
Yesterday I graduated.
Okay. Steve, congratulations.
Thank you. Thank
this makes you a little bit superior maybe to your teammates now.
Yeah, I guess it means I can boss them around a little bit. I don't know. I doubt they'll listen to me, though.
Tough workout here again today.
Yeah, pretty tough. We're really getting ready for a high state.
Compare if you would. A year ago at this time when you guys were preparing to a bowl, attitude-wise and condition-wise?
Well, I think condition-wise is not that much difference because this time last year we were practicing down at school, but attitude-wise is a lot different. We know more of what to expect. Last year we were real unsure. We'd never been to a bowl, and we got down there and we were sort of, I don't know, spaced out about the whole thing, I guess, but this year we got our feet on the ground and we feel real good about it.
Could it be called maturity?
I think so.
All right, overall, as you look at someone like Ohio State, your impressions about playing a team such as this?
Well, we're going to have to be at our best to beat them, Jim. They're big and they're fast, just like you'd expect from Ohio State. They're probably the best team personnel-wise we've played all year.
And you think the Tigers can be ready to do the job?
Well, I don't think we'd be going out there if I didn't think we'd be ready.
How close to the Razor did you get this morning, Joe?
Well, not very close. We're going to go ahead and let them grow until the game.
I'm more interested in your physical condition and your impressions of how the team's coming along.
I think we're doing outstanding. I think we surprised the coaches in the shape we were in the first day, and I think everybody's doing pretty well, and I think the mental attitude of the whole team is real good right now.
You know, there's such a large group of you seniors who, of course, are going out as the last collegiate game, and I suppose you put a little extra into it for that reason.
You're right. We've got 26 of us here, and this is our last chance. We realized we screwed up pretty bad last year at Jacksonville. And we're out to prove ourselves and prove to people in Florida we can play football and go out on a good note.
You came to Clemson University. You've been able to make a name for yourself. But I think that it's in your mind and everyone's mind the name you could make by beating Ohio State.
That's right. I'm not really worried about the things I've done. I'm worried about the things that the team has done. I think we made a name for ourselves across the country the last 2 years. And personal honors and goals are just things that come through winning and stuff.
All right, you're on the offensive side of the ledger. That's where all of your work is contained here this week and next week as well. What about the other side? Do you ever pay any attention to what D's doing?
No, we don't really pay much attention to them, except when we have to go against them. And we go against them just a very little first defense, but we know they're going to do a good job, and we don't really worry about them much.
Okay, JB, last time around for you as a collegian, and I know you remember a year ago what happened up in Jacksonville.
Yeah, I guess you're right about that. You can't the fact about I know that, and we'll always probably remember it. But the thing now is that I think we learned a lot from that last year, and so going into the 7-8 season, and the team has come a long way since last year at the Gator Bowl at that time, and progressed a lot and built a lot of confidence in each other. And I think the atmosphere and everything for the team is a lot better than it was last year, and a lot of the players feel more confident because last year was the thing that we were winning games, but we just had come off a losing season. This year, we had just come off a winning season. Everything's been building up, and everything's just been clicking right for us. And I think everything is really working great for us now.
You're one of 26 that I think has supplied great attitude for the team. But I like another thing you guys have done. You've sort of passed it along to the underclassmen, given them something to build on.
Yes. Well, I'm when I first came here, I think they come off a 7-4 season, which was great then. And so we kind of became on our own and had a lot of young players playing, and we didn't really have too good season like we thought we was going to have. But we learned a lot from the seniors that we had, and we went into the my junior year that season. We really played good, and so we come around to this year, and we played better, and we got a lot of the young players involved in the football and what it's going to take to win around at Clemson, make them feel like they're a part of a winning program, and they got something to live up to, and it's proven just by the hard work that we do and the outcome that comes for us, winning games and the winning ACC championship, coming to two bowl games. I think it can't help the fact from learning something from it. I'm glad to see that the players that signed with us really did, because they're going to really get a chance to be associated with some first-class football.
You tell me that you're a bit sore. I think that's a good indication there's been hard work.
Yeah, you're right about that. So we've been working hard, and we're going to continue to work hard until the 29th. So I just hope I get some of the kinks worked out by then, which I think we probably will, because this was designed to be a really work week and get everybody back in the tone of playing football. And I think Coach Ford is doing a really good job of that, of keeping everybody in condition and working us real hard. And so next week, we're just going to polish up a few things and get ready for the 29th.
Bubba, turn around and look over your right shoulder. Does that remind you of some of the folks you left behind as the team's top hitter this year?
Yes. It was a great asset to me to receive such a reward, to be in the player with the most hard hits on the team. I felt that I can contribute more to our team if I can do this come next Friday night against Ohio State.
Well, I'm certain that you'll be out there giving it your all. It's been a hard week of practice here in Daytona, and for you, a few little back problems there. Nothing serious, I hope.
Yes, Jim. I have a minor back injury. I'm just trying to get my timing down. That's what happened. You know, it's kind of hard to come back into playing ball after you've been out for so long, like two or three weeks we've been out, and now we're just trying to get back into the fundamentals of football. And now we're at the point where injuries are kind of creeping up on us, but we'll be injury prone come next week. We'll be ready, we'll be set, and we'll be ready for Ohio State.
Okay, you and Randy, of course, two of the smaller linebackers in college football as a team, and a pretty good, solid offensive line for Ohio State. Is it going to be a great challenge?
Yes, definitely. They put me in the mind of Georgia Tech. They big, they physical, they get at you. But me and Randy feel that we're able to move quicker against them. We know that we don't have the size of a pro linebacker, but we have the quickness and agilities to outquick the offensive big lineman. And we feel that this is going to be a plus for us against Ohio State.
How about the team's attitude, in your opinion? Are they ready to play?
We feel that our attitude is positive. We feel that our players are going at it in a positive attitude. And we feel that we're having a good conditioning workout down here in Daytona Beach. And we feel that when we get up in Jacksonville, that it's going to be Ohio State and nothing but Ohio State.
Had their moments to be honored at Daytona Beach. The Touchdown Club and the Chamber of Commerce held a luncheon and introduced the team to football fans of the area.
practice was tough all week at Daytona Beach. Field days can be wearisome. There was that moment, however, on Saturday the 23rd when the morning session had ended and there was one more hard-hitting session on tap that afternoon. There was a moment for hanging out the emotions. The Tigers at the Treasure Island Inn provided a Christmas party as a farewell prior to the team's trip to Jacksonville on Sunday. Everyone was there, including Santa Claus. Visit from an Ohio State cheerleader.
Hey, Randy, Randy will be after in a minute.
Sunday's Christmas Eve trip to Jacksonville took less than 2 hours, and it included a stopover at the world-famous Daytona International Speedway. Christmas Day at Jacksonville, a Christmas away from home, but a buffet of food not soon to be forgotten.
There were gifts from the Gator Bowl committee and the Tigers hosts at the Sea Turtle Inn. The word on the Tigers all season. Before the first game was played, Greenville Piedmont sports editor Abe Hardesty expressed on a Tiger special we produced in Greenville, if Steve Fuller remains healthy for 11 games, the Tigers will play 12. It proved to be good prophecy. Fuller and 25 of his teammates will close out their Clemson careers in tonight's Gator Bowl matchup against Ohio State. Steve, tonight's the night, the last time you'll don a Tiger uniform and go out and represent Clemson University. A lot of mixed emotions, maybe.
No question about it. It's a thing that, you know, it's not going to mean that much right now because, you know, we're excited and ready to play. But, you know, when you sit down maybe, you know, tomorrow afternoon or something like that, it's going to hit you and it's going to be a sad moment. But, like I said, it's important that we do well tonight. And if we turn out all right, I think it'll leave a lot of good memories and we won't have that much to worry about.
Do you think the plan this year, as opposed to the one last year, was a better one? I mean, by working out at Daytona and getting prepared?
I'm sure it was. We went down to Daytona for a week and had nothing to do but worry about getting ready. And we had a lot of free time. And we, you know, didn't have that much to think about football, although we did have good practice and good intensity when we were out there. And we came up here, and we're still not doing that many things up here. So it was a good week, and I feel like we're a lot better prepared, and our attitude's a lot better, and it's got to turn out good for us, I hope.
As you see the Ohio State defense, and as you see your teammates, do you think you're capable of moving the ball well?
Yes, I'm sure we are. You know, the thing that's been the key to our offense all year is just executing and not turning the ball over. And when we didn't turn it over, we moved the ball. And we're going to show them something they hadn't seen in a while. We show them a little bit of, you know, different things that they're not used to up there in the Big Ten. So we feel like that's to our advantage. They've got good players. And I think the important thing is going to be who gets off to the better start.
Is it a big emotional lift to play a Big Ten team with the stature that Ohio State's gained?
Yes, I think it's a great opportunity for us, especially on the type of program that we've got started now, and it's definitely on the way up, and this will take one big giant step for us, and it'll make things, you know, 5 years from now so much better.
Steve, 26 of you guys will not return next year. What kind of attitude do you think the team that does return will have as football progresses at Clemson?
Well, that's the thing I feel, you know, best about. I feel like we've done the best job at leaving something good behind. We've got some young players who are real proud to wear the orange and are excited about Clemson University, and that's the important thing, first off. And they're good players on top of that. So with the recruiting year we had this year, and I'm sure we'll get next year, I think we're going to leave behind a good foundation. I think they're going to win a lot of football games.
Yeah, a head coaching career with a premier bowl classic against a nationally recognized power is something most would seldom even dream of, let alone accomplish. Tonight, however, it is the hand of fate reaching out to give the opportunity to a young man. And he is young. He is energetic, knowledgeable, and most of all, respected. He is Danny Ford.
And in just a few minutes, you'll take your first Tiger team onto the field, an Orange Bowl date against Ohio State. You've had a lot of time to work now. Do you feel that it was better preparation than perhaps it was a year ago when you took the break between workouts?
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, we feel like we did the right thing by our workout schedule. But, you know, whether you never know if you win, it's right. If you lose, you know, you can question yourself 1,000 times. But, you know, we feel like that we did the best thing that for our kids and in our situation.
One of the major areas of concern has been the fact that Lester Brown walked around for several days with a cast on his hand. Any response?
Well, Lester's got from what I understand by the doctors, you know, he's got a badly sprung or maybe a slight little break or fracture in his hand. He has been held out of practice, but we expect him to play and play well.
All right, timing is such an important factor in football games. And this is, of course, what you gear practice towards. Would you feel that you've accomplished that and that you're on schedule?
I think we are. We had a good practice up until Tuesday. Tuesday was a slow practice for us, and we came back good Wednesday and just a little bit Thursday. So, you know, we feel like, you know, everything's been real good. Everything's been positive. The kids got a positive attitude. The kids think they can go out and win a football game. Coaches think that we can go out and win it, too. So, you know, we just waste to remain to be seen who's going to win a football game.
All right, as I recall, this is the third Gator Bowl for you, one as a player, two as a coach, first time as a head coach. And I would really like to have you respond right now as just how you feel minutes away from kickoff.
Well, I've never have liked Gator Bowl. Every time I've been to the Gator Bowl, we've been, you know, we've been just thrown to the wolves. One year we played in, Missouri ran through us like, you know, like dang water, I guess. They just beat the devil out of us. Last year, Pitt beat the devil out of us. Maybe third time's a charm, you know. It's a great bowl. It's one of the best bowls I've ever been to. And this trip, we had a super time and good work. And as far as, you know, yeah, I just hope the third time's a charm, and if we play good, it could be the charm.
Can you compare Clemson as a team with anybody you've played with?
Well, they're diversified much, much more than these passing teams we've met, much more, because they can run the ball, and they play good defense. They're a good all-around football team, no doubt about it. They couldn't have got as high in the ratings they did if they weren't.
Is it a motivation for you to play a higher-ranked team?
Well, it gives us something to drive at, doesn't it?
Is there any one thing that concerns you more than another thing about Clemson?
Well, if it did, I probably wouldn't mention it. You just don't dare. And you can say, no, there isn't, or yes, there isn't, and lie to you a little bit. I can't lie. I'm a horrible liar. I just can't do it. So what do? I just say nothing instead. So I'm bad copy anymore. But I'll be damned if I lie, and I'll be damned if I'll give my plans away. It's a real problem. I'd make a lousy newspaper man.
Coach, would a loss in the Gator Bowl be more of a negative in your situation than a victory would be a positive, considering the
status? Oh, Jesus. I don't know. It would depend on how the thing happened, I think. But I don't know. You'll have to figure that one. You're righter about that than I would.
What you're looking at is the right hand of Lester Brown. It has looked like that since Friday, the 22nd day of December. But here now is Lester Brown. And Lester, you're coming out of that for game time tonight. We want to know a little bit about it, though. It's been a well-kept secret around the Tiger camp.
Well, yes, sir. It's been a great secret. But I think today we're going to try and come out of it. Doc Hoover's going to cut it out, and we're going to go out and try and work with it and see what we can accomplish.
And, of course, that means that Clemson's 1,000-plus yard rusher is going to play football against Ohio State.
Yes, sir, and I'm hoping that it'd be the best game I performed this year.
Lester, I recall when you were in high school, you went into a state championship game playing with Myrtle Beach under similar circumstances.
Yes, sir, it's been the same injury. And I kind of like, I've forgotten all about it. Like, the fans usually make me forget about things, and I had this same kind of injury, so, like, I'm going into this game and try and forget about it also.
As I recall, that was a mighty big night for you as a senior in high school.
Yes, sir. Great big night.
Now, what we're wishing is that Lester Brown comes out of that cast and has a similar performance against Ohio State. But regardless, I know that you have said all year, what happens up front is what counts for you. And you're totally dependent on these guys. And, of course, I know that you rely on them and you believe in them.
Yes, sir, Mr. Fields. I feel like if they do the job up front, then I wouldn't have to worry about my right hand.
So it is, the Clemson Tigers en route now to a Gator Bowl meeting against the Buckeyes of Ohio State. It takes place very shortly. And this is the group of kids that has rolled to a 10-1 mark during the course of the season and now prepares for their big engagement against the Buckeyes, hopeful of gaining victory number 11. Well, here it is again, a familiar sight to Tiger fans, the Gator Bowl, 1 year later. You'll recall that in 1977, not a very exciting experience for the Tigers as they came into Jacksonville, Florida, only to lose to the Pitt Panthers. But a chance for redemption, and it all happens here tonight. A year ago, some 72,000 fans packed their way into the Gator Bowl. Most of them wore orange. That again will be repeated tonight, you can be guaranteed. But I think, too, that you'll see an improved Tiger football team, because this is one that is dedicated to going out and playing well against the Buckeyes of Ohio State. The trip to the Gator Bowl in Jacksonville came by way of a big victory over the Citadel that started the season. Then a disappointing 12-0 loss to the Georgia Bulldogs. However, from that point on, it was all victories for the Tigers. They won the Atlantic Coast Conference Championship. They defeated their arch rival, the Gamecocks of South Carolina. And they, of course, accepted this berth in the Gator Bowl to go against Ohio State. For many of the Tiger players, it's been a weird experience, to say the least. Some of them now will play under their fifth head coach. Charlie Pell, of course, resigning after the season had ended, before this team came to the Gator Bowl to accept the head coaching job at Florida University. He's not on hand for tonight's game. But Danny Ford, his successor, is. And those players have rallied around him. You wonder, can Danny Ford lead this team onto the field? Will they play with the inspiration that they showed throughout the course of the season? The answer to that, in my opinion, yes. The Tigers will play well tonight. They've worked hard. They've pointed towards this game. And they're ready to go out and take on the Buckeyes of Ohio State. From Jacksonville, Florida, this is Jim Phillips.